Hello friends, welcome to Wanted Talks. In this video, I will tell you how you can post HTML form data to Google Spreadsheet by writing few lines of script and using ajax. Now here we will use Google Form and Google Spreadsheet, and I have HTML which will be available for download. I will keep these links at the description. So let's see how it is working. Let's fill these entities. As I have got 10,000 views on my last video, and that video was lengthy and the code was complicated, that's why I'm again making a video to make it simple. Now let's see how it's working. Now choose any field and click on register. Now we at the front end we have successfully posted the data. In the Google form also we have captured the response, which you can see here. In the Google spreadsheet also we have got the response. So if your requirement is the same, so I will now teach you how you can make it for yourself, and for the reference I will give you this HTML for download, and I will share my Google form and Google spreadsheet as well. So let's edit it and see what's happening in this code. Now at the top, let's go to top. Here I have only used the jquery because I'm using some validations and making ajax request, that's why I need jquery. And here below I have some variables, which is getting the value of four fields which I have in the HTML form. I will show you. And here I'm making some validation of the empty fields and the logics for phone number as well. And here this is the main code. Only these line of code will post your data to Google spreadsheet. Now here at the top, this URL is of Google form URL, which I will tell you how you will get it and how you will get this data into the fields. You can add the fields, you can less the fields depending on your requirement later. But here, as we have the four fields, and this is the form, this is the only the HTML form I'm using. Now I have one name field, email field, mobile number field, and one select area. And here I have some options. Now I will give you this code. Now I am telling you how you can do this, how you will make a form of your own and you will post the data. So starting from very beginning, go to Google Forms. Now go to Google Forms, and here you will get an option to create one blank form for you. Click on that, and here you have to keep on creating the fields by clicking on the plus button. And please remember, keep it short answer, as we do not need to put any of the validation here, otherwise after successful request also there's a chances of the failure from these validations. So do not keep it, and keep it as a short answer. Now make a very simple form and put the name of the fields you want in your HTML form. Now it will be short answer. So I have completed my four fields. Now give it a form any name, we will do it later. Now this is the view of your form. So after clicking on the view button, I've got this URL. This is the final URL which we will use in the HTML, as I have shown before also. Now keep form response as it is and paste till here, otherwise it will give you error. Now we are set here. Click edit. Now by editing it, we will create one spreadsheet for it from where the data will be posted, and we will take out some dynamic values by using the developer tools by inspecting the HTML, which I am showing you here. So let's give it a name, for example, font tutorial form. Now by inspecting it, you can get, so let me zoom it a bit. Now here, after clicking on the view button, use developer tool, otherwise it will not give you the entity field. Now click on the input, you will get this entity field for every input field. So like for example, let's collect all in a notepad. This is the second field. Now we are finding the third one. And the last one. Remember to click on the input, that only that you will get this field, this name field, and within the name you will get this entity attribute. Now we have got the URL of the form, we have got the entity fields. That's all you need to make a successful entity to Google spreadsheet. Now paste it here. Now if you have more fields, it is comma separated, you can add commas and include more fields. So I'm giving 4 as an example. So this is the fourth field, we are putting it here, and the same values we have to put at the top in the form within name attribute. That's why I have copied it once in my notepad. So this is the way you can follow as I am doing it, and if you face any problem, you can come in the comment section anytime. I will give you the response as quick as possible. So this is the second field, now the third field, and the last one. Now after this, we are all set. So click a spreadsheet by clicking on this spreadsheet button and give it a name. If you have the existing one, you can choose that, otherwise create a new one. So we have created a new one, it has been open. I will share you this spreadsheet as well. You can first of all test it. So coming back here, refreshing the HTML page. Now we are posting the new form test. My mail, a form number, and choosing a field, click on register now. Now let's see, you have got the response here. So this is all this video was all about. We have got the response in the spreadsheet as well. So if you want to make something else, you can leave it as a comment. I will make a video on that. And do subscribe, this is my new channel. If you want to support, do subscribe, like and share. And if you want more videos like these, so you can keep you can turn on the notification button as well. You will get the notification of my video. So thank you for watching this video. Have a great day.